only 45 kilometers and you arrive at El Hayz Oasis. This very natural place, where its inhabitants still depend on agriculture, is the main source of income, as well as grazing cattle and sheep.
Here starts the real adventure and thrill. Our tour guide Khalid Khalifa will let us discover the beautiful treasure in Egypt through our trip to Wadi Tibinia.
Yeah, we are now in El Gharbiya, Nakf El Gharbiya. Nakf El Gharbiya, around 6 kilometers from Bahariya Oasis. One of the 13 passes get out and in of Bahariya. Without the 13 passes, you can't go out of Bahariya. So Bahariya depression, I mean. And we are on the way to go Itibiniya. And Itibiniya is a group of depressions from the third geologist period. We will go there and we will see how it looks like, and we can explain it there. And here in this pass, it's very interesting, bring you over 100 meter high from the ground, and down you see different sediment, soft sand and stones, and up here you see all the rocks from the limestones from the fourth geologist period here. Look at the stone here. It's not normal stone. I mean, we have many stones in the desert here. But this stone is very special because it's very remarkable. That's in the way of the caravan. As we are going in a flat area, very long flat area. For this, you will find all the road, all the way of the caravan marked by stone like this up the hill you look there, and also another one down there, two stones over each other. And soon you come to the path, you will have a bigger alam. So this stone, it's called alam, and very big. Look there, up here, up the mount, up the hill there. You'll see the alam up there. So the alam means just a pile of stone, but it's a remarkable point to guide the people through the caravan way during the day. Of course, in the night you have the stars, but the alam during the day, you can will see it from far distance. Hey, look, how interesting in the middle of the desert here, which looks no inhabitants, no life. You see a stone circle. It looks a bit rooted, but a stone circle like this means a lot. If the stone circle above a riverbed, that means it's used for hunting, because you use also, you have two stone circles. One is used for hunting, and one as oracle, for serving the gods. And as there's no river next to us, so that means this circle used as a temple. But why is here? This circle is here because, as I mentioned before, we are going to Tipinia. And Tipinia, it's a group of depressions. So the depressions was full of water, was life. So around the depressions, you find tools from prehistoric time. We will find stones, and even stone circles. Of course, you have to worship the god in this stone circle. We'll be right back.
places through this tour is the Crystal Mountain, where you can find some amazing crystal formations which make it a perfect place to pose for photos.
There you can find different kinds of stones with different colors and different shapes. While taking the tour to Wadi Tibniya, you may also find unusual things that can make you stop and contemplate God's creations.
Look, how interesting, after driving almost 50 kilometers in the desert. Almost looks like flat. And just near this rock, limestone rock, grows this small bush without water. From where this bush gets the water? This bush, of course, gets the water from two points. First, from the rain, which is very rare in the desert, never more than 16 millimeter, or from the night dew. So from the night dew, it gets the water stored. And this leaves, you can see, the leaves here is very thick. So because this plant stores the water of the dew and start to keep it, and soon the next rain coming start to grow again and again. So it gets green when there is rain, and when it's dry, it stops growing and keeps the water inside. Either this kind also keeps in the leaves or in the roots till the next rain it comes again.
To the end of this wonderful trip to the valley of Tibniya, where you can find different fossils.
And now you can see how the erosion, the wind erosion and the flood erosion. The flood which washed all this, and the wind which eroded all these nice formations around. made different sculptures, different shapes. There it looks like a castle. Oh. And all the ruins. Look, man. And then you see also a lot of fossils in the ground. And look now here. Great. It's also crystallite gypsum in the shape of lava, but it looks very close to the skeleton, to the back skeleton, probably a big fish, fossilized. And the fossilization is the changing of the main material of the skeleton to another material which more resistant and more stronger, so can last longer. And here it was fossilized to crystallite gypsum, and looks like the shape of the crystal, and you can see clear the skeleton in the ground. Wonderful.
We have met with foreigners from different countries who are amazed by this wonderful treasure in Egypt.
For them it was quite a unique vacation through which they enjoyed the beauty of nature.
Bahariya is a wonderful place for to start safaris. In every direction you can go, and I hope that more and more people will discover that the desert is something healthy for the soul, for the body, and for the spirit even. So a lot of people are invited to visit Egypt without fear, for the Egyptians are full of love, and say spend this love to everybody. They are welcoming them here in Egypt.
We do a lot of meditation, and the silence in this desert is so outstanding. And I hope you Egypt people will take care of this beautiful, beautiful land.
That is the first time in the desert. It's a wonderful place. A magic place, and this experience was extraordinary for me. The sand, the light, the shadows, and these pyramids built by God. I am very glad for this experience. And I think Egypt is a wonderful place.
يمنع عيون وصدر حنون الوش تقول مرايا شوف كم يوم ما ضبت النوم عشان ما انتيش معايا يمنع عيون وصدر حنون الوش تقول مرايا شوف كم يوم ما ضبت النوم عشان ما انتيش معايا عشان ما انتيش معايا يمنع عيون وصدر حنون الوش تقول مرايا شوف كم يوم ما ضبت النوم عشان ما انتيش معايا يمنع عيون وصدر حنون الوش تقول مرايا شوف كم يوم ما ضبت النوم عشان ما انتيش معايا عشان ما انتيش معايا
Got a good story? Get in touch with Nile TV. Send us your videos, pictures, and stories. Email us on our website. Contact us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter. And also Google Plus. Be part of making the news. Only on Nile TV International.
Good afternoon, it's 3 p.m. here in Cairo. Welcome to this edition of Panorama News. For the next 45 minutes, we'll be joining you with the latest updates in all of the political, the business and the sports segments. I'm Yasmin Bakir. I'll be filling in for the political segment. The headlines are coming up. Court sentences ousted President Mohamed Morsi to death in jailbreak case. Election Law Committee reduces number of constituencies in parliamentary elections. And authorities extend the opening of Rafah border crossing with the Gaza Strip. Welcome back. Cairo Criminal Court sentenced to death ousted President and Brotherhood leader Mohamed Morsi in the case related to the mass jailbreak during the 25th of January 2011 revolution. The court also sentenced to death the general guide of the Brotherhood terrorist organization, Mohamed Badia, as well as Isam Al-Aryan, Rashad Al-Bayoumi, and Mohammed Saad Al-Katatni. Meanwhile, other Brotherhood leaders, Mohammed Biltagi, Safwat Hegazi, and Saad Al-Husseini, were sentenced to life in prison, and 97 others were sentenced to death in absentia, including runaway cleric Yusuf Al-Qaradawi. The defendants were convicted for killing and kidnapping civilians and policemen, along with attacking police facilities and breaking out of jail during the uprising against former President Hosni Mubarak. In an earlier session, the same court sentenced Morsi to 25 years in prison in a case related to conspiring with foreign groups. The general guide of the Brotherhood terrorist organization, Mohammadiyah, was also sentenced to 25 years in jail in the same case. In total, 17 were given life sentences. The court also sentenced leader Khairat al-Shatir, Muhammad al-Biltagi, and Ahmed Abu Ati to death in the same case. Their sentences were also handed to 13 other defendants in absentia, and the verdict can be appealed. Minister of Transitional Justice Councillor Ibrahim Al-Hinaidi said Tuesday that he will submit to the